secretary of the club right there. Yes. Okay, the president. Okay, the president of the club, of the 6 Footers club, is Kemi Olowoye Otegbate at the middle. Yeah, you can see her there. The secretary of the club is Foluke Akoshile, and also a member of the club, Ayobami Michael. You can see how tall these ladies are looking. Interesting one.
Yes,
you're
indeed.
Welcome to the studio.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. All right, so let's get into it first of all.
Maybe we should
perhaps
let
you
them
now
sit
down.
Back.
Let's begin the conversation. Now, this is quite interesting because I used to only think I would read them in books. I remember the tallest woman in the world, Rumseye Gelgi, who flew her first, you know, got on the plane for the first time last year in September. And she said this today for her is novel. And I think this is novel for a lot of young girls today while having you on the show. So tell us really what inspired this from the beginning.
Okay. As a founder, I have been above 6 feet since age 15 and very thin. So you can imagine I would be gangling. And I was really, really body shamed. But we could not speak out. In my country, we hardly speak out. We endure pain and shame. I grew up in Lagos Island. If I go to Balogun Market, my Igbo brothers will hide shame me and clap as if I committed an offense. They will shout, "Ogologo, you won't carry leg go heaven." When I get home, I will not tell my parents. When next they want me to go to Balogun, I will say I will not go. For a long time, I could not get my size. I will wear good clothes, I will not see my size. That's part of the pain. I attended a mixed secondary school. In my classroom, when we are just joking and playing, your classmates will just shame you. They will just shut up. My nickname then was terrible, but I will mention it because now I am proud of my height. Then I didn't know. They were calling me long vehicle. So for a girl child, who will be happy to be called long vehicle? Long vehicle in Lagos was molue, horrible molue. So I was not happy. There was another tall girl in my class that one stopped coming for lessons, I mean for some classes, because she could not take it. I managed to sit down and read and pass. Sometimes she comes just to do exams because the boys will hide shame her. So as I grew up, I discovered the advantages. After my youth service, on the street, I see people stopping me. That was when modeling evolved. Calendar, TV, billboard. And I would see heads of those agencies then stopping. I used to think they want to kidnap me. They would say, no, tell your brother, tell your auntie, tell someone to come with you. We want you to be our model. You are unusual. That was when I started building self-esteem. That was, imagine, it was after youth service. So while I was growing up, I wasn't happy until I got the advantage. So during my youth service, I met someone who was 6'3" for the first time in my life. I was shocked. And I asked her, were you height shamed? She said, yes. So as I grow up, when we see ourselves, we attract one another. And we started talking and we realized most of us were height shamed, but we never told anyone.
You know, the thing is surprising because many people actually admire people that are tall, particularly the men.
After we have overcome the pain.
The height shame. Okay, let's hear from your secretary. Yes. Have you ever been height shamed? And what exactly does it look? Because from looking at you here, you are good. You look, you know, trim and nice and tall, which should be an asset, really.
Yes, that's a
slogan. Let's get to hear from you.
You know, when you become an adult, I think by then you've already filled out a bit and all that. It's the height shaming reduces, but as a girl, it's terrible because most times tall girls are tall and thin. So wherever you go, to people are looking like, even people around you wonder that, do you want to touch heaven? Where are you going to? You start hiding before you start having low self-esteem if you are not careful as a girl. So when I met our president, I had to just key into the objective because I know a lot of young girls be going through the same kind of thing. Mm. They need people to mentor them, to tell them that don't worry, your height is okay. You don't have to develop low self-esteem because you are very tall.
Mm. Okay, let me come to Abayomi. I mean, high shaming, heightism. A lot of people would ask, what was it like in school for you? Because even that, you talked about, you know, going to school and having to watch a friend miss classes and only write exams. But even in the tertiary institution, I know that there would even be more of that as you're getting into adulthood. What was it like for you?
The thing is, what we're forgetting, because you said it's a bit unusual because people find it attractive. That is when we become adults, that people, oh, you're tall, it's attractive. But we forget when we're in school, you know, we're kids, so you can't really blame anybody. There's bullying, and then there's a lot of, you know, you become a lot of people become intimidated by your height. Let's say the boys, if they're not as tall as you yet, because it takes a while for
the boys to catch up.
Boys, yes. So you get made fun of, you know, and I'm a fashion designer, and that's one of the things that made me a fashion designer, because when you shop online, it's very hard to get your length of pants. That's another thing that fashion designers don't put into consideration. When you buy ready to wear, it's very hard to find your length of pants when you're very tall. So the discrimination is not just from school or like around, it's even from, let's say you go shopping.
Everywhere.
Me personally, I find it very hard to find my size of pants.
Are you
nervous? There will always be three quarters.
What of shoes?
You're shaking. Sorry, well. She's shaking. Are you nervous?
No, I'm not.
Just breathe. Relax.
No, I'm not.
Relax.
I'm okay. I'm okay. I'm trying to put all my points together.
All right.
So you get made fun of a lot. So being a member of the Six Footers is actually very encouraging. It's very uplifting. You get to meet people that are just like you, that have the same mindsets, the same goals. And it makes you feel, you have a feeling of belonging that feels absolutely great. So like being a member of the Six Footers is like an advantage to other tall girls.
So how do you fetch the girls that join your club now? You just see them on the road, or you advertise how exactly? Because I know there are a lot of them out there and they want to be part of this club.
When I was growing up, we were not many, but luckily, I don't know what they eat now. We have many tall girls. Actually, the tallest of our members is 6'7". I would have wanted her to come, but she's gone for campaign in her state, in Nabia. She's 6'7", and each time when we started the campaign, anybody that knows me knows a tall girl, they send me their number. They send me their number, and then we also advertised online on Facebook and Instagram. And I was shocked when people started responding. There is a lady that works with immigration. She does not go out. She said she used to feel ashamed of herself, that she was happy to see kindred spirits, that she has a daughter who is 12 and she's already 6 feet, that she's sad that her daughter will go through the same thing. I said, no, you've got in the family. They will not go through it. We are going to take advantage of this height and shout to the world. They must make our sizes available for us in shoes, in clothes, and then by the time we build the self-esteem and send out heavy signal, all those girl children out there thinking they are inferior, they are not. They actually stand out. That's why our slogan is, 6 footers walk tall.
Your height is an asset.
Absolutely.
You know, but we didn't know. So it's a legacy project for the coming generation, for that tall girl child out there. I have a friend whose daughter is almost my height, and she slouches already at 15. She already feels sad. So the mother, they understand, but she will just say, please talk to her. This is your daughter. Please talk to her. And I told her, see, already her back is bent, which wasn't necessary.
She's struggling to bring down the height.
Yeah. Yes. Instead of her parents talking to her in love, they will beat the...
And say, stop slouching.
Stop slouching. And that makes her...
Even more depressed.
Thank you. When I start telling her, you are going to be a beauty queen. You are going to be a model. See Agbani, see Oluchi. So that's what we are trying to do.
Okay, then let me come in here to Foluke. Just before, when we were talking about this backstage, I was talking to a colleague of mine, Hisoje Momo, and we talked about heights and women. And he said, well, for a guy, he's quite attracted to him, even right from when he was young. Perhaps it's because of the upbringing and, you know, the literacy around it. I used myself, for instance, in my hostel, I was one of the tallest, and I was the one that did all the cobwebbing. You know, they would always come to me to cobweb because they knew that my hands could reach where their hands could not reach. And, you know, so I don't know how you're going to, you know, penetrate schools, especially, you know, secondary schools or perhaps even primary schools, because catching them young is very important for Luke. I do not know if you agree
with
that.
It's actually part of our plans.
Okay.
We are partnering with sports agencies and ministries to provide, I mean, something like a talent hunt for students. So that if you are in secondary school and you already show signs of being a six-footer, we will take advantage through our open sports talent hunt. What can you do? Maybe they'll ask them to run. We've actually sent letters out in that regard, and we have partner coaches in that department. So that by the time they are 25, they have become a star because of their height. Mm.
Now, I know that even basketball, you need such height
to especially play
such kind of sports. So, did you take advantage of your height to go into any of those sports?
Of course, I played a lot of basketball when I was younger.
Do you still do that now? Maybe you would have become a world champion.
Maybe as we have a club like this thing, it would have worked for me.
I did not. I was too, I don't want to say sad. I was hiding.
All right, so we wish you the very best with your club and many women out there, many young girls, I'm sure they'll be interested. If you can just quickly mention maybe the how they can reach you. Mm-hmm. Yes, please. Quickly.
Okay, on the Facebook and Instagram, we are at Six Footers Club. The Six Footers is Six F-U-T-A-S Club. It's deliberate because some organizations abroad have started using the F-O-O-T-E-R, and I know we are going to be big.
Absolutely.
And we don't want them to see us or whatever, or we start quarreling when we have done all the
hard work.
You. So on Instagram and Facebook, please join us. All those tall girls outside, you are not alone. You are an asset. Don't let anyone hide shame you.
Okay.
And we are on YouTube, Six Footers Club International.
They will definitely follow you on social media, and I'm sure Abayomi